Baduru Aluma, the head teacher of K-Seed Secondary School in Yumbe District, has managed to turn the school around by sheer faith. He was contacted by a friend in 2016 to help set up the school. The friend told him the government was going to start a seed school in Yumbe and trusted that if there was one person who could get the job done, it was him.
2016, I was contacted by one of the OBs whom I taught in L11 in Koboko Mode. Said there's opportunity in Yumbe where they are starting a seed school in the sub-county. And he has seen my capability of grooming that school. That trust he built on me. Even many of the locals did not know me.
In the community, Aluma was a stranger and there was no functioning secondary school.
And we started our mobilization the holiday of December 2015. Started moving from village to village that we are going to start a seed school which government is coming to build. And from there, indeed, parents picked interest, but they could not see future.
First person who received him in this place, I have two children in this school. One is a female, the other one is male. Since they had never seen a secondary like that.
He began to walk village to village introducing himself. He knew that for the school to succeed, he needed community support. Aluma says he had very little to work with at the time, but pictured what the school could be. He mobilized his friends, convincing them to come and teach at the school. The attraction was that at least they would get government jobs.
All of us who had some opportunity in private schools, we are now benefiting from that private school to do the work for KCD. That was there. But the biggest hope was getting government job in secondary. Our first admissions, we admitted around 50. We picked teachers from different places. My friends in Koboko, I got some from Yumbe here. I assembled all of them to start the teaching.
There were no classroom blocks, so they resorted to start teaching under trees as they waited for structures to be set up.
If you can check our sub-county around here, there's been no secondary school around us. The blocks were not here. We started with the HM under trees, in which classes were not enough. Some of them were taken to the primary schools. Beginning from zero, coming to this level is not an easy thing.
The teachers also struggled because they had no accommodation, so they rented a grass-thatched house where they would sleep.
Accommodation, up to date, there is no accommodation for the staff. We rented a house just there, a very open house. All teachers sleep in that house, but including me as the head teacher, we sleep. You put your mattresses. And in the morning, you are very smart, you go and teach. And that was how we motivated ourselves. Our target was we shall produce good name for this school and people will start coming.
To build the number of learners, they introduced sports. Through these activities, they would participate alongside other schools and make a name for themselves so more students would want to study there.
In 2017, we said, no, we cannot now teach only in a class. For us to advertise, let us now bring in sports. It was 2016, we could not participate even in getting a ball was a problem. With only one set of uniform, we were able to come with a trophy. And because of that, as I talk now, we have a very big number of students from Maracha.
The first time the school participated in the national exams, five got second grade, which was celebrated. From the students that sat during the COVID period, five got first class.
The second set that sat was now 2020 Corona era, and they were 49. Out of the 49, we were able to produce five first grades, and we emerged the best in the district. Even New Vision, I thank New Vision for the publication. Our names appeared now. From one, we reached to 539. All those students who passed in the first grade, I want to tell you, they said they are not going elsewhere.
For parents who cannot afford fees, Aluma encourages them to bring food.
The biggest initiative we have is the school fees or payments in form of food items. Now, when I brought that, I tell you, everybody say, I can. I only ask, can't you really produce a basin of beans? I can. Say, bring. The child eats, the staff eats, And that's all, life goes on.
Teachers Making a Difference is part of Ugandans Making a Difference project implemented by New Vision since 2008. The project targets teachers in public primary and secondary schools across the country.